by the screen of hairs, whereas women, for the long silken tufts, flower only in their dainty crevices. With an ingenuity touchingly marvelous, such as one sees only on angels and on an icon, they resemble the cheek, they were dimpled with happiness. Oh, to be naked now, seeking peace and sunshine, my face basking before your glorious ass, and both of us free to murmur and moan. Thank you. Okay. And this is titled A Lover's Cock. It's the title poem from the anthology. A lover's cock. Even when it is soft, your cock is still my pleasure. White gold between your thighs, against the ball's dark allure. My lover's balls, jocose, bellicose, they're bad, the brother of rich, proud, purplish, pinkish, brownish, leather. The left ball, by just a bit, hangs lower than the right one. The willy, sanctimonious rogue, Christ, for what reason? Your pretty gadget is plump and velvety from the pubic bone to the foreskin, three-fourths covering the crow's rose, crow's rosy crown, which under the soft skin distends a little, the heavy tip of the cock head takes form, with pout displays its lips. In all grateful love, I'll embrace with my lips, let the hand caress your cock, seize it in a brazen grip, it draws the drinks back. The tender purple cockhead, without further ado, suddenly, joyously, splendidly, flowers out. Thank you. love. I gave him promises. He said,